Mary Adams, please.
Ramagat Concordia Ogresinti, I'm Lats the Taishak Ogresta Focal Co Brown, Ayarnatu, Pui Bas, Dolores O'Riordan, Ogrestar Smuinta, Lessa Chaila, Ogresta Karja, Egan, Vronok, Shaw. And on the Fianna Fáil leader's question, perhaps he will support Sinn Féin's PMB on the trolley crisis later on this evening. But I want to return, Cian Coria, to the issue of the absence of adequate respite care services for children living with a disability. And you have often said, Taoiseach, that you welcome constructive proposals from the opposition. And on the 6th of December last year, I put a costed and modest proposal to you to increase these services. And you committed to examine these proposals, which I also give to you in detail in writing. And you have yet to respond to that. A week after I made that proposal, Minister Finian McGrath announced he had secured an additional $10 million for respite services. And as I've told you many times, there are no emergency services in my constituency in Louth and very limited respite beds. And the Minister's announcement was presented in part as an urgent response to this. However, it's now emerged that this money is grossly inadequate and that a task force to examine it hasn't even met yet. Now, most of this involves citizens in a family setting, but it's now emerged that children with a disability who are in the care of the state are being denied these facilities. An investigation by the Ombudsman for Children, Dr. Niall Muldoon, found that the state has been denying the necessary supports to the woman who for 14 years has been fostering Molly. Molly is a teenager who has Down syndrome and severe autism. Molly's carer had accused the HSE and Tusla of abandoning her and leaving her financially, emotionally and physically drained. And the Ombudsman has found that the HSE abdicated its responsibility to Molly's foster mother by its refusal to fund her respite care. And the stress this causes, I'm sure you know this, is absolutely horrific. This report is a damning report. It found that the state's actions had a negative effect on Molly, that she did not have the opportunity to reach her full potential. It found that the actions of the state were contrary to fair and sound practice. Now, there are 472 children, including Molly, with disabilities in the care of the state. Among its recommendations, the Ombudsman has called for a respite action plan for children with a disability in the care of the state and children with disability in the community at large. And these recommendations have been accepted by the HSE in Tusla. However, the HSE points out that its commitment in this area is ultimately resource dependent. In other words, Taoiseach, it's over to you. Now, this is not one of those shameful historical episodes of the neglect or ill-treatment of children in the care of the state. This is now. We can't blame anybody else if this continues. This is on our watch. So do you accept this is a damning report? Do you accept its recommendations? And will you provide the resources needed?
Thank you, Deputy Adams. Taoiseach.
Thanks very much. Just first of all, I want to say that the government decided this morning that we won't oppose your motion on hospital overcrowding today. We want to be in solutions mode and discuss solutions, and therefore we will put down our own motion, but we won't oppose it. And we hope that the debate that does occur this week will be solution focused, which is, I think, something that we all want. In terms of the proposal that you made to me before Christmas. The proposal you made didn't add up because, as you know, in your Sinn Féin alternative budget, you proposed a smaller increase in funding for health and disability than we actually allocated. So your proposal didn't add up. But we responded in kind, and that's more important, by providing an extra $10 million for respite in the year ahead, and also providing, as we will later this year, a statutory right for all people in receipt of carers allowance to see their GP for free, which comes on top of our decision last year to provide all children with a severe disability with a medical card, a full medical card, as a statutory right for the first time. In terms of the report on the case of Molly, I want to say that TUSLA and the HSE accept the Ombudsman report in full and are committed to implementing its recommendations. I know both Minister McGrath, who I discussed with this morning, and Minister Zappone take the findings very seriously. The investigation highlights a gap in the provision and coordination of supports and services by TUSLA and the HSE to children with a diagnosed moderate or severe disability in foster care. And I think we all respect and value the role of foster carers, particularly foster parents who take on children who have special needs or additional needs or disabilities. The report published by the Ombudsman in relation to the complaint, which was made in 2014 by a foster carer on behalf of her foster daughter, is of real concern to the government. Action is already underway, including a review of supports available to Molly and monitoring her care to ensure that her needs are being met into the future. Furthermore, TUSA and the HSE are reviewing all similar cases of children with moderate or severe disabilities who are in foster care with a view to maximising coordination, cooperation and support, because there must be very many other Mollies out there. We want to make sure that the state agencies review all similar cases. We must also continue to support foster carers who, like Molly's family, have opened their homes to children who can't live with their own families. As I mentioned prior to Christmas, we provided an additional $10 million for respite care to support people with disabilities across the state and their carers. Also, a joint working protocol has been made between TUSA and the HSE. This joint working protocol to ensure that TUSA and HSE work more closely together is in place since last year, but only came into effect on the 1st of January this year, which is only a few days ago. And both agencies are absolutely committed to ongoing implementation of the protocol across the country.
With your answer, Taoiseach, first of all, send me a detailed, considered response in writing to the written proposal I put to you, and I'll respond to that at that time. I welcome the fact that you're saying that you're not going to oppose our PMB. Well, na habere, Taoiseach, yane. Don't just talk about it, Taoiseach. Act on the recommendations that we are putting forward. This report, you say the ministers are taking it very seriously. That's the understatement. This is a damning report. This is a damning report which indicts the state and its agencies for the way that it's treated this child and her foster mother. So I'm asking you to act on the report and to provide the resources provided. You didn't answer that point. HSE say that they are dependent on the resources that they are getting. Finally, John Collier, the Taoiseach should know that workers in Section 39 agencies are balloting for industrial action because they're being denied pay restoration. And you need to give these workers their entitlements. Otherwise, added to all these other problems, this strike will go ahead and the crisis will be compounded. And this is all about rights. These children with disabilities are carers, whether in the community or in the care of the state, have rights.
Thank you, Deputy.
And the state is actively denying them their rights at this time. And I'm asking you to correct that, Taoiseach.
Taoiseach.
We're providing additional resources all the time for our health service and for people with disabilities. And obviously we need to establish what additional resources may be required to implement this report in full. And to apply it to other similar cases, but that's certainly what we intend to do. And even sometimes when you provide the financial resources, you can have difficulty finding staff, but that is something that we will continue to work on and continue to improve. And just to give you one small example, take the whole area of special needs assistance. Now about 14,000 special needs assistants in the state, more special needs assistants than we have Gardaí or doctors. If you go back 7 or 8 years ago, that wouldn't have been the case. And that's just one small example of the government's commitment to providing people with disabilities with opportunity and the opportunity they deserve to be equal citizens in our state. In relation to Section 29, you'll know that, or Section 39s, you'll know that I've discussed that before and answered in the House as to how we intend to proceed on that.
Thank you very much.